Yeah, hello students. Today we'll discuss about and we'll understand the hydrosphere, which is very important. And as you know, hydro is nothing but the water, so which is very important for all the living organisms and also includes bacteria. So all life, directly, indirectly, we depend on the water bodies. So, but the very interesting part is less than 1% is only useful for the human beings that will reach to the earth's crust. So imagine just less than 1%, and this is very important for us because so the reason why we say that water is very expensive in terms of save water and all. Why? Because this 1%, less than 1% of water, if it is going waste and to the ocean, so without using it in a proper way, then it's a very, it may conflict or thing. So in the hydrosphere, under this, we discuss about the hydrological cycle, which is nothing but it's a exchange of one phase to the other phase. For example, in oceans, water is in the form of, liquid phase, and, in the water vapor, it is in the form of gas, and in ice, it is in the form of solid. So this exchange of phases is nothing but the hydrological cycle. So mathematically, we can also take this as RF is equals to RO and ET, which is nothing but RF is rainfall, which is the first form of the water reaching to the earth's crust is rainfall. And this is runoff and evapotranspiration. As you know, evaporation is water, going to the from ocean to or rivers to the surf on the atmosphere, and transpiration is nothing but plants, the trees, is taking out the water or particles to the atmosphere. That is the transpiration. So now we'll discuss about the six stages of hydrological cycle. The first stage, evaporation, as we just learned that from the water bodies like rivers, lakes, oceans. So water is evaporating due to the sun rays and sunlight. So that will water particles will evaporate into the sky or in the atmosphere. So that is the first process in going out. And there you will find the transportation process. Once if they go on the top, forming the cloud of water particles. So these clouds will slowly moving, transporting to the other areas from the sea place or river place to the other places. Then there will be a condensation process where these little water particles is forming, water droplets, and also these water droplets forming the kind of, condensed particle are, going, and once if it is meeting to the surface, for example, in hilly areas where it will touch that coldest region or cold region, and you will get the precipitation process. So this is the first and the primary mechanism of this hydrological cycle, where the water is coming from the atmosphere to the earth's crust or, on the surface. So this precipitation, once if it is, touching the climatical changes, also the factors, which will force and propels the water to precipitate. And once if there is a rainfall, so you will get some of the water on the hillside will flow. Like, for example, I just show you here in the figure. So once it is going evaporating from the from the sea or ocean or water body to the atmosphere, so then we'll be getting the clouds, and these clouds moving and transportation is taking place of. Once if they touch the warmer part and also the then there you will get the condensation is nothing but here the phase is changing. For example, here liquid phase of the water is changing to the gaseous phase or water vapor. Here in the condensation process, again gaseous phase to the liquid phase. That means again it is becoming droplets. And here in the precipitation, this liquid rainfall is falling on the surface of the earth, where sometimes where there is a steep flow, so runoff will take place. And this runoff, sometimes it will again reach back to the ocean through rivers, and sometimes it will penetrate in the surface of the earth, forming groundwater, So groundwater, again, it is, you know, it's nothing but from the, due to rain fall only, that will recharge and charge to the ground through some fissures and other features of the earth's crust. So this runoff water, again, you know, going back to the ocean. So this is how from one form to the other form, exchange of phases within the atmosphere, hydrosphere, and this is nothing but your hydrological cycle. And again, under this hydrological cycle, we have some number of sub cycles which operates within this mechanism. Yeah, and there is a very important and the very typical structures you will find in the groundwater, where in the groundwater, when the surface is, you know, having some small fissure or something, groundwater will pump out and you will get water like this from the surface. So which is nothing but we call as artesian well. Artesian wells are usually formed in the, you know, formed by the groundwater, so taking out from the surface.